Hi everyone and welcome back. So in this video we will talk in detail about the new life cycle methods example. First example we have done. So we are actually just trying to see what all methods are getting triggered. So here we actually trying to print what is the method calling sequence. So what we are doing is we have put a console.log everywhere, and in the component did mount we are updating the state, so it will again execute this render cycle and component will receive props, will trigger, and then render will trigger. So if you see what is happening here is constructor component derived state from props, render, and component did update, component did mount. Okay, component did mount will trigger the state update after 1 second. If you see this, there is a delay of 1 second is coming. Yeah, so these set of methods are coming after 1 second. So constructor get derived state from props, render. Now there is a component did mount. It actually updating the state. So get derived state from props and render is getting triggered. Now you see this component get derived state from props is getting checked every time. Now let's go into the deep and try to see even when you are changing the state here. You see it is handle click is getting triggered. It is updating the state. So get derived state from props is getting triggered and then render is happening, right? So this is the sequence flow we are getting for the update life cycle and for the initialized life cycle, because this is getting initialized. Now you are updating a state, or component did mount is updating the state and executing the update life cycle. Okay, so few things we need to understand here is about this derived state from props and component did mount. Okay, get derived state from props, same, it works same as component will receive props we had earlier. What component will receive props used to do, here I will show in the code. It used to check the previous props and it used to see, okay, do we need to actually render the component or do anything. Component will receive props, this is actually taking next props. So here we used to check if next props dot some particular variable is not same as next props dot, you can say show, is not same as this dot props dot show. That means we received a new props from the parent component. In that case we used to do this dot set state blah blah. Okay, here we can say that I have this show property, so get it from next props only and show it. This is what we used to do with the component will receive props, but now it is unsafe, so we are putting something like this. Now same responsibility is there with this get derived state from props, right? So get derived state from props is executing whenever the component is receiving new props. This function's main responsibility is ensuring that state and props of the component are in sync. When it is requiring replace the, we are replacing the component will receive props with this get derived state from props. Okay, so get derived state from props function is invoked when component is mounted as well as receiving the new props whenever they are changed or not. Important thing is, so get derived state from props method is getting triggered when the component is mounted or they are receiving the new props whether they are changed or not. So you can see the lot of iterations that get derived state from props is getting executed and we are able to see it. So here in this case what we can do is we can just check that execute this method when props and state are not in sync in this particular case. So we can see props dot show not equal equal to state dot show, then only just update this from the props. So what we can do here is if props dot show not equal equal to state dot show, then only we can do is return show with whatever we are getting from props dot show. Okay, now we are getting it, we are just checking the state and props and we are replacing the local state with the props because we are deriving the state from the props. So get derived state from props may be called multiple times for a single update, so it's important to avoid any kind of side effect. this is only the main responsibility is to sync the state and props whenever it is happening. Then we see this component did update and component did mount, sorry. Component did mount is executed after first render of the client, right? So once you have rendered the component, now this component did mount will trigger, and you can write anything, set timeout, set interval, keep executing it, and you just update the state, re-render will happen. So mostly what we do in this particular block is we make an API call, get the data and all these things. So what you can do is exios.get some URL, okay, and then we just get a dot then, we get a response from there. Okay, so const data equal to response.data. So we receive data and we can actually set state based on what we have received. Here we can do this dot set state. If we have some data property in the state, we can set it. This is the use of this component did mount, and once you have the data, you can actually iterate onto this data and you can render it. So here we can have a data as an empty array, and this data can be used here to iterate using UL li tag. So here we can actually, so this kind of syntax we have already seen. Okay, what we can do is we can just loop onto it. So we can create a UL tag. Okay, we just need to, we can just directly run the loop onto it, this dot state dot data dot map. It will not be a null. So we have the items, and same as we can just return li tag with some data. In the li tag you can just print something which you need and just provide a key with proper index. Index we can pass from the iteration itself if we are not getting anything unique. Okay, and do something. Okay, this is just a simple example, but this is how we are using this component did mount. Now there is another method which we need to understand, is get snapshot before update. So what get snapshot before update is, it is taking two arguments. One is previous props and previous state. Previous props and state. Anything. So this is first argument will be a prop, second argument will be a state. So get snapshot before update is another new lifecycle method introduced recently. It used mostly if you need to read the current DOM. For example, you have an application in which new messages are getting added up on top of screen. If user is getting scrolling, right? So get snapshot before update, you can calculate the current scroll position, maintain through the DOM updates, all these things you can do with this. Okay, and it is getting triggered after, once you have done the rendering and before component did update. Okay, we have these deprecated methods. Component will receive props, component will update, component did update. Right, you can just use unsafe and you can use that. Okay, let's see other examples in the coming videos. Thanks everyone.